Now let us look at the question number 61 to 70. So question number 61 says the CPU can perform read or write operations directly on. Now you just focus on the term directly, because CPU cannot directly read on hard disk, write on hard disk. CPU generally write on RAM, and from RAM we write data to the hard disk. Okay, so CPU can read or write operations directly from RAM. CPU cannot write on ROM. CPU cannot write on hard disk. Why you cannot write on ROM? Because it is a read-only memory. It cannot write on hard disk, and it cannot write on EEPROM. So CPU can only write on RAM. So question number 62 says, which is an example of non-volatile memory. Now when I'm saying non-volatile memory, that means when you turn off the system, then the memory should not wipe off. But the RAM, cache memory, or VLSI. So actually VLSI is not used to store data. It is not a memory, but RAM and cache is a memory. Now this RAM, random access memory, and cache memory, whenever you turn off the computer or restart your computer, they will be completely wiped off, or all the data will be deleted. But data which is present in ROM is already embedded. Again, you cannot write any data onto the ROM because it is already hardware configured. So ROM is not a non-volatile, is an example of a non-volatile memory. Now question number 63 says the term not related to a pixel, to a printer. Now here we have DPI, PPM, head, and pixel. So this DPI is dots per inch. So DPI is related to printers. PPM is related to printer. Head is related to printer. Head means the read-write head that is going to write on the printer. But pixel is not it. Pixel is for images, for screens we use pixels. Pixels we do not use in terms of printers, because in printers we use DPI or PPM. Okay, so here pixel is not a term which is related to the printers. Now look at these questions. Which is the only decision making unit in of CPU? Now there's only one decision making unit, and that unit is called as arithmetical and logical units, ALU. Okay, so let me figure out these questions, this question one by one. See, cache memory you cannot make decision, register file you cannot make decision, and there are two things that are left. Number one is ALU, third one is control and timing unit. Now this control and timing unit is used to synchronize between different parts or components of the computer. It is just used so that these components will be able to perform actions simultaneously. But when you have ALU used to perform calculations. Now according to those calculations we perform operations which is based on the control and timing unit. But let us say what, from my point of view, what I see is that ALU is the place where we perform calculations. It is arithmetical logical unit, and according to the output of ALU we perform different actions, and those actions are performed by control and timing unit. So combination of these two is required, but if I have to give one answer, then I'll give you ALU as the answer. Now for question number 65, they are saying processing capability of a computer is decided by. So the processing capability is generally dependent on your CPU, right? So our CPU architecture also at the same time. Now here clock frequency, yes, somewhat we can decide processing capability, but that also depends on CPU architecture. Memory size, again, maybe. Bus size may not be. Okay, so it may not be a correct answer. So I'll say this is a pretty confusing question, because I cannot say processing capability because there are different factors on which the processing capability of a computer is dependent on. I'll say because we have for CPU we have memories, because memory size may not be a processing capability, but it can be a factor that affects the processing capability. And clock frequency, I'll say clock frequency, it's actually at what clock your CPU is running. So maybe clock frequency can be an answer, but I'll say clock frequency may not be. Okay, so we have to figure out this question. Just you suggest me what is the answer of this problem, but I'll see the processing capability of computers dependent on your CPU, and the CPU may be dependent on the clock frequency. Maybe that can be how, I mean, clock frequency generated to the CPU itself. So maybe this can be a correct answer, but I cannot figure out the right answer to this problem. Maybe the problem is not formulated correctly, but you tell me what your point of view for this question number 65. Now for question number 66, they're saying the term algorithm refers to. Now this algorithm is the set of instructions. I mean, algorithm is saying how defining the logic of solving a particular problem. Now when I'm saying algorithm, it can say it is the logic of the program, yes. Solution of the problem, no. Programming of a problem, no. So I'll say the algorithm is referred to the logic of the program and nothing else. Okay, now let us look at the question number 67. It says the flow chart is a flow chart is a program planning. Yes, you can say that a flow chart is a program planning. B, way of problem definition, no. Pictorial representation of an algorithm, it can be, but I'll say it is program planning will be a better option as compared to this. Okay, now for question number 68, this says the term DFD stands for. Now DFD stands for the data flow diagram. So data flow depiction is not there, data feeding device is not there, it is data flow diagram. Now 69 is saying which computer language is not a high level language. Now we have four language here: assembly language, C language, C++ language and Java. Now C, C++ and Java, they are considered as high level programming language, as assembly language is not a high level programming language here. Now question number 70 says which is not an object oriented programming language. C++, as we know, it is object oriented programming language. Actually the trend of object oriented programming language is started by C++ only. It started like this: we were having a language B in 1970s. Now Dennis Ritchie designed C language again in 1970s and it became very famous. In 1980s we found out that we still have to add more functionalities in C language to make it more powerful. So there are two branches divided here. One is developed by Next Computers, which was a company by Steve Jobs, and they developed Objective-C, and they developed the Mac and iOS operating system in Objective-C, and other family, they Bajanes Strip, they developed C++ language and it was having object-oriented features. Now the object-oriented features of C++ are again redesigned in Java completely thoroughly from the scratch, and the functionalities of Java, they are adapted by Visual Basic or Microsoft C#, so VC++ you can say. So you can see here, C is not an object-oriented programming language, whereas C++, Java and VC++, they are object-oriented programming languages. Now in the next videos, let us look at the question number 71 to question number 80.